Guys, if you're like me, you love 7.62 NATO, and you love them even more when it's a C308. Yes, sir, that is fun. What's going on, guys? Clint here with Classic Firearms, and we've got Alec back today.
What's up, guys?
Guys, we're hanging out here at Take Aim Range, and we got ourselves a nice looking battle rifle right here. This is the Century C308, and talk about a cool rifle. Chambered in 7.62 NATO or 308 Winchester, you can't go wrong with something like this because this is proven reliable.
C308.
You'll figure out why we said it like that anyway. I'm making fun of Alec here, but if you guys aren't familiar with these rifles specifically, the ones that have the OG wood on them or the wood furniture, these are actually all made from original SETME parts kits, minus the new US receiver and barrel. Everything else, surplus, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's nice because you get that kind of classic look to it, but you get the new, you know, US parts, which is really nice. So you get something that's functional, has the classic look to it. I think that caters to a lot of people out there.
Absolutely. And the SETME was actually originally designed by the Spanish in 1952, which HK then pretty much based the G3 rifle off of.
Yep, with the roller delay lock system.
Exactly. Yes. And you can't go wrong with that at all. Just, again, a reliable firearm. Now, having shot this guy, I gotta tell you, it is probably one of the smoothest, lowest recoiling 308s I've ever shot. I got it out.
Yeah.
And I think that has to do with the operating system,
yeah,
but also this brake right up front.
Yeah, the Chevron muzzle brake is a really nice touch. It helps kind of port that gas out.
And I noticed that. Mag dumping this thing here, it just stayed flat.
Yeah.
It was great. But talking a little bit more about this, guys, it uses standard SETME or HKG3, HK91 type mags, and those are readily available.
Yes.
You can find those all over the place, so no big deal when it comes to the mags. Also, too, being chambered in 7.62 NATO, also readily available.
Packs punch.
Can't go wrong with it, man.
And then also you have the tunable.
Yeah.
See, so you're messing me up, man. I know. You have the tunable gas system up front, guys. So if you're going to run different pressure loads, weights, stuff like that, you have the ability to tune your rifle.
Yeah.
So, I mean, these things, they just shoot, man. I mean, what can you say about them?
Yeah, this is your end of the world gun right here. I'd say between like an AK and this guy here, man, you are just, you're living it.
Yeah, and you're then you have the Picatinny rail up top too, if you want to throw an optic on it, and especially with 7.62 with 51 or 308, you can really reach out and touch with this rifle.
Oh yeah, absolutely, guys. So check out again, the C308s are made from original SETME parts kits again, except for the receiver and the barrel, which is kind of cool because you know you're getting a new, not a shot out barrel or anything. But ultimately, we're happy we've got these guys. And again, just that beautiful wood furniture. Granted, some of the wood's gonna vary. This is just one of the ones that I pulled out of the stack and I was really happy with how it turned out. So you might, again, these are surplus parts. So you might get some that are a little dinged up. I was just thinking, I was like, I wonder if any of these have trench art or something, you know?
I don't know, maybe. Yeah.
All right, I might go digging, but one of the things we're gonna talk about too is just the mag release on this guy. It does have just your standard type of push button released right up here. So for me, I kind of have to change my shooting position because it's just out of reach of my index. I can come up here.
Yeah.
I can come up here with my middle finger and drop it, but I almost found it easier just to kind of switch positions and then go back. Simple drill with the C308, guys. I love these type of roller lock guns here. So let's just do a mag reload with it. And I'm just gonna have to get used to it because the mag release on this guy is way up here. And that takes a little bit of force to drop that guy. So, hopefully I don't look too stupid. Let's just let's try this out really quick here. Just like that. So it'll take a little bit of getting used to, especially on this system here, where you're having to reach out a little bit further than what you're actually holding the gun to grab a hold of that handle and come back, lock it into place, drop that mag, reload, slap it down, and then continue on. It takes a little bit of practice, but hey, a lot of people in all around the world have got this thing down to a T, so I'm sure we can too. Check them out, guys. Again, the C308s, classics as this one's called. And
you can't go wrong.
No, you can't go wrong. I think I'll end it there. You good?
I'm good.
All right, cool. Guys, hey, we appreciate your business.
God bless.
And we'll see you next time at classicfirearms.com.